Today we're going to talk about who should do MBA, why should you do MBA, and when should you do MBA. MBA is one of the most common topics I've been asked to talk about, and today I want to go in a bit more depth and talk about some more angles of MBA that I didn't cover in the last video. If you do missed the last video about doing MBA before work experience or after experience, please click on the link and watch that video and then come and watch this video as well. So let's get started. Now, before you fully watch till the end, don't forget to click on the subscribe button. MBA, Management of Business Administration. One of the most popular courses today I see young graduates taking after they finish their bachelor degree. Everyone around me or around us seems to be doing a management degree these days, especially MBA. But I thought it's important for you all to get a context. And let me give you some statistics first. Just in India, every year, about 5 lakh students graduate with an MBA. And the requirement from corporates is barely 30% of that, which means so many of them are doing, but not all of them are going to be getting really good jobs. And if you take the real statistics from MBA schools as well, just the top 20 to 30% of even premium college MBAs get really top jobs and top fat pay packages. 100% placements, though being claimed by many MBA colleges, is rarely the reality. I'm sure many of you have been attracted with this 100% placement guarantee message from many colleges, and you probably taken an MBA. But that's not really the fact everywhere. It's really important to also remember that only 30% of Fortune 500 company CEOs have an MBA. Do you know Bill Gates, Mark Zuckerberg, Albert Einstein, many other top CEOs in many organizations, including in India, don't have an MBA. I never went to an MBA school as well. Neither did some of the very senior people in my own organization. But it has not stopped us from achieving the pinnacle of success. So I want all of you to remember, MBA is not the only way for you to achieve success in a corporate life. It's just one of the ways, one of the modes. But then you must be wondering, do I need an MBA to become a CEO? Well, no. I've given you some examples. In many cases, it is just a filtering mechanism. You know, we have so many applications that come through for jobs, and just a filtering mechanism for management-based roles only. And that's the scenario that's existing in today's corporate environment. Now, who should be doing MBA? Firstly, if your aspiration to be a leader in a management position, sales, marketing, operations, management positions, then you can consider doing an MBA. But if your aspiration is hardcore technical, R&D, being a teacher, doing a role like a scientist, then do a master in science degree, MS, or a master in engineering degree. Don't do an MBA degree. This is very important for you to understand. This is to mention who should do an MBA. Another important aspect you should know about MBA degree in India: you don't require CAT for every college, and the CAT exam is based on a lot of good academic performance as well. So if you're poor in academics, there's no point in you repeatedly writing CAT year after year, because many colleges look at your academic performance and only give you an admission based on that. There are, of course, some colleges that take a holistic view of your work experience, entrepreneurial thinking, then your academics as well, and your whole rounded personality. So depending on the kind of academics you've had, the kind of person you are, then go and choose the right college. The other thing is, there are specific colleges specializing in certain things, like Indian Institute of Foreign Trade for international business, NITI for operations, supply chain, XLRI for HR. You got to look at these, which college is specializing in what and what is that you want to specialize, and accordingly choose the college. Just don't write CAT blindly. Do some research and take an informed decision about these things. I've seen students mindlessly writing CAT year after year and then getting disappointed and irritated about why life isn't moving. So with all this context in place, I've spoken about who has to do MBA, then when should you do MBA? You should do MBA after at least 3 to 5 years of work experience. And this is what I spoke about in the old video, but just to reiterate, when you're working in an organization, you're implementing various procedures, practices, you're driving results and achievements and initiatives. And when you then, after this work experience, go and do the MBA, you understand the intentions behind this, the theory behind this, the purposes behind those ideas that you used and the solutions that you implemented, then everything comes together. So that is what I would suggest as when you should do an MBA. Now, finally, the big question, why should you do an MBA? The most important reason to do an MBA must be you want to become a better version based on what I mentioned before about who should do an MBA. If you want to become a better leader, you want to know leadership qualities. You want to become more smarter on those areas. Then you should be thinking about doing an MBA. You want to switch your field or your career? You are in pharmaceutical, for example, and you want to move into a different industry altogether. Then look at doing an MBA. I've had a lot of people who are in hardcore engineering and they want to move into sales and marketing. Then they do an MBA and it helps. But let me tell you one thing, as a CEO of an organization, when I look at a CV, even if you have an MBA or not, it's during the interview, group discussions, case study presentations, we look for the qualities. So even if you don't have an MBA, but you have those skills and competencies, that can be enough as well. So what I'm trying to say is, even if you're doing MBA, the purpose should be to really develop those competencies and skills. Don't just think that the paper MBA will give you value everywhere. There may be some places you will get the value, but that's only for a matter of 1 or 2 years. After that, if your performance is the same as everybody else, you will be treated the same. There will be no difference for the organization. It may just give you a kickstart in finding a great opportunity. It's another reason why people do an MBA. You may get into a big organization, you may get into a good role in the start, but if you don't sustain a good performance, that will be lost very soon as well. The other biggest advantage of MBA is when you go to study, you're studying with students from different states, maybe even different countries, different cultures. So you will learn a lot of new things. You will improve your networking with those people. And they may all go to different companies in future, take senior positions, and that can become a valuable experience for you. That's another purpose of doing MBA. The next reason for doing MBA is, overall, you become better in terms of street smartness. You can think on your feet because you're put into difficult situations during your education. You're given case studies to solve. That's another reason. The next reason I find is, you get a variety of experience of different industries. You have visiting professors from various companies, maybe from another university worldwide. A world exposure brings in the curriculum. So you become more worldly. Your knowledge increases. This is another reason why MBA is important. But in certain companies, there's a prerequisite to have an MBA. So there you probably need an MBA as well. Overall, finally, it can help you get a better pay and a better income and a better company as well. But that's the final outcome. But as I said, the most important reason why you should do an MBA is to really improve your competencies and skills. So these are the reasons why you should do an MBA. I hope this was eye-opening for you of who should do an MBA, when should you do an MBA, why you should do an MBA, and certain statistics I shared about MBA. Please listen to the full video and then take a decision about applying for MBA, writing your CAT exams. If you have done MBA and you have listened to this full video, I would love to hear your perspective as well. What was your experience of MBA? Do the things that I mentioned resonate with you? Do you want to add some more things that I've missed out? Please do share on your comments and I would love to have this conversation with all of you. But still, I see you all in the next video. Stay fit, stay positive, keep chasing obscene success.